Hello guys, welcome to my this video, and in this JavaScript tutorial I will show you how you can get base URL. So guys, in the previous tutorial of JavaScript I had shown you how to get the full current URL. I mean guys, here you can see I have opened this page. This page has no data, and here you can see the URL of this page: c:\users/anudo-desktop-javascript-index.html. So this is the full URL. So in the previous tutorial I had shown you that how to get this full URL dynamically, because sometime we face a scenario that time we are to fetch the full URL from our current page. So that's why I had shown that tutorial, and I also faced that type of situation. So that's why I made a video. Okay, and guys, if you didn't watch my previous tutorial, so I will provide the link in description on and also I button, so you can check and you can watch this video. So if you watch this video, so this video will help you. And here I will write the just one line of code, and after written this one line of code you will get the base URL. So here is guys, base URL means this is our full URL, and base URL means which base on this URL. Okay, so that is base URL. So here I will show you what is the base URL of this site. Okay, so again I am saying I will just try to give you the one example of base URL. Like here, this is the project you can see. I mean, this is one website you can see here, and here is the base URL, this one. Okay, and this one is the our page URL. So the full URL is total, and the base URL is only this one. I mean, if I simply to say, the base URL is our domain name. So sometime we our domain name may be the abcd.com, google.com, amazon.com, flipkart.com. So these are the domain name and these are the base URL. So sometime we need a scenario that is we are to fetch a base URL. So in this tutorial just I will write a code, simple one line of code, and by this code you will get the base URL. Okay, so now guys, here this is my project, and here is my blog site. Every code whatever I upload in YouTube, every video, so that source code I write in this blog. So you can read this blog, and this blog link I also provide in my description, so you can check the description. So this blog link I will provide in description. So here I have written how to get the base URL, so you can watch this blog, and you can take the source code and you can put it in your project, so it will be easy to you don't have to be type manually the code. Okay, and here you can watch this video, then you will be understand in practically. So now guys, for showing that, I will open my Visual Studio code editor. So here is the code editor, and here you can see I have opened index.html file, and don't be confused to see the link. Here is a Bootstrap CDN link, I mean Bootstrap CSS link. This is Google font, and this is Font Awesome. You can see the Font Awesome link, and this is style.css. I have made a style page, so that's link I have added. And this is jQuery. This one is Bootstrap JS link. You can see here Bootstrap JS, and this is custom JS file, the same like CSS. I have made a custom JS file, so I have put the link here. So this link we don't need in this code, so don't be confused to look at this link. So now in the body tag, just I will write first of all a button. So button is type button, and when I will click the button, so then I will fetch our base URL. That means first of all I will create the button, and the button name I will write, that is get base URL. So base URL. So now I will save, and here I will leave this. So here you can see the button. So here I will add one thing, that is container. So we know guys, container is the Bootstrap class. If anyone doesn't know, so I am saying that container is a Bootstrap class. So container. Okay, so this class is not related to this code. Here I have just added this class because for adding some space in left and right. So if I refresh, so you will find here the it adds space in left and also right. But you can see here, because in the right has no data, but it's added space in left and right. And this container class is comes from Bootstrap. This is Bootstrap class. I mean, it's a some CSS property already is written in this container class, and this is the boot this class is comes from Bootstrap class. So and I can use this Bootstrap class. You can see I have added the Bootstrap CSS link, and by this link I can use this class. So if you want to add Bootstrap, so you can check another tutorial, that is how to get Bootstrap link, and you can use Bootstrap class also. So there are defined kinds of Bootstrap class. I have just used only container, and now I have added a button. So when I will click this button, so then I will get the base URL from this URL. So now where I will show this URL after getting this base URL from this URL, I mean here just I have to be show under the button, so I mean below the button. So here for that below the button I will write a p tag, and not a p tag, just I will write a h1 tag. So if I write the h1 tag, so the size of the font will be increased and it will be more visible to you. So now in the h1 tag, just I will take an id is demo. Now save, and now guys, when I will click this button, then I will get the base URL. So for that here I have to be write a click method. So on click in JavaScript we write it on click, and here I will write get base URL. So this is our method name. Someone call is function, someone call is method, both are right. Okay, so this is our method name. This method name you can write according to you, but this is our predefined JavaScript method. I mean when I will click this button and want to fire any event, that time we write on click. If want to fire any event on hover on button, so we should write here mouse hover. So there are different types of event. Here I am using on click event, and now the make function name is get base URL. Okay, so function name you can write according to you, I mean as per your choice, and this function's definition I will write below the body tag. So here is the end of body tag. So just above this end of the body tag, here I will write script, because when we write anything in JavaScript code, then we write it inside the script tag. So that's why I have written the script tag. And guys, here I'm explaining like beginner, because some beginner watch my video, so that's why I'm making this video and full try to explain fully. That is, you will not get any confused. So that's why I'm making like begin. So guys, here just I will paste this method name and curly braces. So the syntax of this to write the method, that is you have to be just write a method name, and you can define method two ways. Like you can write function keyword like this way. So this is the simple, and otherwise you can write fade arrow function. After upgrading JavaScript version 6, I mean someone called it ES6, or it's a short form of ECMAScript 6. So both are the right, ECMAScript 6 and ES6 is the short form of ECMAScript 6, and it's a JavaScript version. JavaScript version 6 we call it ES6, okay, or ECMAScript 6. So when it comes ECMAScript 6, so it provides us fade arrow function. So how to write fade arrow function? Just method name equals to, after that parenthesis, and after that equals to, and the arrow. So I hope you can see the syntax to define fade arrow function. And guys, simple functions and the fade arrow function has some difference, but that will I will explain in another video. So here guys, I will use normal function, that is using a function keyword this way, but you can use fade arrow function also. And now just here I will define our method. So guys, just here, so here you can see when I will click this button, so that means when I will click this button, so it will be called this method, and this method I have written here, and inside this method I will execute some condition. Like here I will write document dot get element by id, and the id is demo, because inside this h1 tag I want to print our fetching base URL. So here the id is demo, so I will copy this demo id, and when we want to print anything in JavaScript, so then we write inner html, and inside this inner html I will write window dot location dot origin. So guys, origin means how our world is originate. I mean, I gave you the example in first, like base URL means you can say simply your domain name, like google.com and flipkart.com. So when we open flipkart.com, so flipkart.com is the base URL, and after that when we open any kind of pages, like again I will show you, then it will be more clear to you. So suppose I want to open flipkart.com, so this is just I will type flipkart, and here I will open flipkart. So here you can see this one is the base URL, and now from here suppose if I go to any product, so here you can see the this one is our base URL, and after that this is our product URL. Okay, so base URL is simply our domain name, you can say, and origin, I mean how our URL is situated, I mean originated. So here window.location.origin, this is the simple one line of code. After using this code you will get your base URL of current page. So now I will save, and just here I will refresh and click. So you can see I'm getting my base URL, this one is my base URL. So this is very important. Sometime you may face a scenario like you need to base URL, and after checking this base URL you have to write a condition. So that time it's very important. So in the previous tutorial I had shown you how to get the full URL of your current page, and in this video just I have shown you how to get the base URL of the current page. So this though both are the very important. So if you hadn't watched my previous tutorial, so I will put the link in description and also cut button, so you can I button, so you can check the link and watch the previous tutorial also. Hope guys this video is helpful to you, and if you want to get more this type of JavaScript video, and if you want to learn Angular or any other technologies, so please subscribe and press the notification bell icon. If you press the notification bell icon, so when I will upload any kind of video, so that will reach up to you.